I'm Mashi Scanlon, the guy on the left.
This is Paul Cheon, also known as Haumph.
Join us on Wednesday nights at 7 p.m. Pacific for Magic TV, where we answer the burning questions posed to us by you, the audience, like Chipotle or La Vic, or where do these guys get their hair done?
And also every single week, we're going to be having a special guest from Channel Fireball, like Louis Scott Vargas, Josh Arleton, Tom Martell, and many others.
With all that and Dark Steel Humphrey, we'll see you next Wednesday.
All right, guys. Hey, have it, everyone. Tom Martell, Channel Fireball, bring you a modern daily here playing the Infect list that I top 8 of the last modern GP with. I made a couple of changes to the list, but not many. I believe that... it's this Elf Belcher deck. This deck is really not good. I mean, really not good. Or it's not the Elf Belcher list. Okay. I have no doubt up against now. I'm getting turn one by storm. Oh, this is interesting. I guess I can have six. Alright, well, crazy stuff is afoot. I mean, Modern's all about doing unfair things to people. And this guy might be trying to do something unfair. Simeon Spirit Guide. Alright. Turn one, Magus of the Moon. So I just lost. If I find one of my fours, that's kind of unreal. Wow. This guy's deck seems horrific, but probably gonna win this game. Kind of funny. So he has Chancellor, Metamorphose, and Storm Entity. If we'd been on the play, we'd win. Also, we just draw a forest. We need a forest right there. He just draws his mountain, of course. And pretty gross. Then he metamorphoses into a desert ritual. Right. Okay, well. Alright, well. He won game one. Bring another dismember here. I mean, these stations look so bad. Don't want to sideboard too much. I don't really think we need to. Second dismember seems good. Probably don't need all these spell skates, is my guess. I haven't really won a match of Modern since the GP, and I lose to stuff like this all the time, so I don't know what's going on. Just like the jankiest decks keep beating me. could bring in Dispel. Dispel and Metamorpho seems great. He has a bunch of rituals too. Or could just bring in Spell Pierce instead. I think I'll bring in Spell Pierce. Cut these spells, guy. It's probably don't need them. Although you can cast them off of Blood Moon lands, which is kind of nice. And also cut like a mutagenic growth here, I think. Don't really know what to expect. Make it bring in Nature's Flames too, since he probably has Blood Moon. But, like, his deck is just like, it's so random. Do we want spells, guy? Blocks. I have no idea how to decide where. There's one, that's one plus the playing these like random decks. Is your opponents will definitely get confused. He has like a bunch of like random dorks, so we probably want to leave this in. I'm gonna leave the Nature's Claims out. I'll probably end up regretting that. I'll probably say turn one me with a Blood Moon or something. This is a keep. And it's not great, but it's fine. Hopefully it doesn't have a removal spell. Okay, good. I'm attack for one Blight Agent here. I'm going to fetch, I think, so that I want to start filling my graveyard for this Become Immense. I do really want to be able to get a second Forest since he's playing Blood Moons. I'm going to not fetch. Realistically, I'm going to play this. I'm going to play a land this turn. Next turn, I'm going to play the Nexus. So if I don't fetch here, I'm just never... I mean, I'm going to do it turn 4. Getting a second Forest on turn 4 is not very exciting. It doesn't have, like, Pyroclasm in his sideboard. That's going to really get us here. He does. He could literally have anything at this point. And there's Snook around you playing, like, Scred, for all we know. I mean, there are a lot of possibilities here. Probe is actually the card I most want to draw as well. Just so I can see what the heck's going on. Oh, off he goes. What's happening over there? I guess I shouldn't cut mana, or I shouldn't cut Gitaxian Probe, I cut Mutagenic Growth. It's really good against Grapeshot. And for all I know, he's playing Grapeshots. Who knows? Okay. Well, unfortunate. I guess we'll just play the Nexus he knows about. He was still actually just... No, not killing him quite next turn. We're almost killing him. Hopefully we can just draw one of our two copies of Dismember here. Huh. Okay. Did not expect him to just concede there. I don't know if these are actually any good, these Spell Pierces. What a bizarre matchup. I just don't know what's going on. He's probably not playing Grapeshot, since he can't actually get a Storm Count high enough for it to be relevant, so I don't think I really need to bring in back in this Growth action. I think we're right. Although the fact that I can cast it with only one green source, I'm going to kind of Mightable Crossbow instead. I think that's certainly relevant. And then the other question is, like, do I want Dispels? Do I want Spellskites? Do I want Nature's Claims? So Spellskite we can cast even if we don't have colored mana, which is nice. Could cut like another Mightable Crossbow, maybe. Could cut a Distortion Strike potentially. Or an Apostle's Blessing. Probably cut an Apostle's Blessing and a Mightable Crossbow for two Spellskites. I don't know if they're actually good, but like his guys are all 2/2s and 3/3s and stuff, so he can block for a little while and try to draw Artist Member, which is pretty nice. I think that's the change I want to make. It's really possible I want these Nature Claims. I wish I could have seen his hand that game. I'm going to do this. I don't know if I want the Nature Claims or not. It wouldn't shock me if he has Blood Moons. But we have like basics and Spell Pierces. I don't want to go overboard. I thought we have like Library Manipulation, so we can't really dig for like, you know, one or two of anyway. And I think we're way more likely to draw the Nature's Claim when we don't want it. Ugh, this hand. Gotta keep this. We have this Memory and a Nexus. The hand's definitely not great. Well, he's off to the races again with his James of the Daniel. He says Gutaxi Probe every game. It's probably the best card in his deck. Gutaxi Probe is really an unfair card in this format. Huh. Okay. Ooh. Alright. So I think I just play the Nexus and say go here. Since we drew this Forest, we don't need to fetch for Forest on turn one. Turn two, we can play this, fetch up a breeding pool potentially. Attack for one. You might have like you could easily have ancient grudge or something, but oh, okay, we drew both forests. Yeah, I'm gonna do. Am I doing this? Am I waiting to try to have vines up? I should not have done this. I reconsidered it. I really don't want to get my Nexus grudged. That might have been really bad. I don't know. Alright, he's gonna do something mean to us. Dismember? No. Alright. So we win the race as it stands right now. We're actually killing him next turn. Although we can't kill him next turn through a removal spell, which is a little scary. Or I guess through an ancient grudge specifically. He probably doesn't have ancient grudge in his deck. Activate. Green divines it. Oh no, we actually do get to kill him through it. Because we get to have an extra mana up. Oh great, okay. So we're killing him next turn through one targeted spell. Okay, so he's just dead. Right, so animate. 2, 4, 8. Yeah, so he's just dead. Right, we're gonna vines it and we're gonna music earth it. Let's make sure I'm not doing the math wrong here somehow. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. Okay. What an odd deck this fellow is playing. All right, well, that was an exciting first match. I'll be back with round two.